Transformer, why is it used? Increase or decrease the voltage, right? So increasing means it's called step up transformer. This one is step down transformer. From 220 volts, it brought it down to 9 volts. Okay, so that is step down transformer. Right? Why do we use these transformers? To prevent power loss during transmission, right? Power transmission. Okay, so that's what you are going to talk about. So there is a small derivation, we'll quickly finish that. So transformer means you have to show something like this. So here you show the primary coil. So this we call it as VP, primary. On this side, we have to show secondary coil. This is your BS. Okay. Of course, you have studied this. It's not a single solid core. It is, what is this called? Laminated core, right? Laminated sheets. Means you have to show the laminated sheets here also. So EP, EMF generated in the primary is proportional to N1. So I am going to call this as number of turns on the primary side, number of turns on the secondary side. So you have studied Faraday's law, right? So EMF one side is N d phi by dt. Yeah, minus because of the Lenz law. Similarly, ES is going to be minus NS d phi by dt. So what is the working principle here in transformer? There is some alternating current on this side. Okay, note the word alternating, because DC current will not produce any changing current, which means there is no change in magnetic flux, which means not induce any current on the other side, right? So the alternating current is given on the primary side, right? So which means the current is changing, which means the magnetic flux is also changing. If the magnetic flux here is changing, the magnetic flux here also changing, which means there will be some induced current in the secondary coil, that's all. So if they ask you what is the principle of working of transformer, right? So take it down. So so principle of working is nothing but AC in primary side. So I'll give you the notes, you have to develop it properly on while you are writing. So alternating current primary side leads to changing current or changing magnetic flux, changing magnetic flux. So this changing magnetic flux is linked with what? Linked with the secondary side. So there is an induced induced EMF in the secondary coil. So they ask you the principle of working is what you are supposed to write. So for derivation, you have to say that on the primary side, this is according to Faraday's law, and this is secondary thing. So I can divide this and this. d phi by dt is the same core, right? So same core means change in magnetic fluxes, same, right? It's not going to be different. Or in an ideal situation, it's going to be same, which means this and this will cancel. Instead of EP, I'm going to call it as VP. VP by VS is equal to NP by NS. So that's the first derivation in transformer. Okay. What does that mean? Higher the number of turns, higher the voltage. Right? So more number of turns means more voltage. So if I want a step down transformer, secondary side I should have less number of coils to reduce the voltage. It's a proportionality game, so you have to play with the proportion. So power in is equal to power out. Why? Power is nothing but energy by time. So energy in is equal to energy out in an ideal transformer, right? In reality, there is going to be some losses. So take it down as ideal transformer. So that means maybe here I should write it as energy in is equal to energy out. What is power formula? V into I. So in on the primary side it is V into I. So VP IP. This side it is VP, sorry, VS IS. So if I want VP by VS, I can write as IS by IP. So here the number of turns is directly proportional, whereas current is not directly proportional, right? That is the purpose of using a transformer. So we want to when you transform the power, right, when you want to transmit power from one point to another, right, from the power plant to your home, right, it has to come through a long distance, which means you want to reduce the current. Why? Only if the current is low, the current losses will be less. I square R. So if I is low, I square R losses will be low.